Do you want to hold yours?
Oh no, it's fine. Thank you.
We enjoy getting away together, but yeah, we're going to be challenged on our hands. They're a big team, so we're well aware of what they can do. But we've been really focusing on what we need to do this weekend.
What's your focus?
Just really improve on what we've been doing. You know, it's obviously something I've been saying for a long time, but I feel that's what the team's been doing at the moment. You know, each week we're sort of gaining confidence in the things that we've been practicing. And you know, last weekend was a real good example of that, but we just want to take that forward now.
What do you see as the Warriors' biggest weakness?
Well, I don't think they've got too many weaknesses. I think you know, they're a quality team right across the park. You know, they've obviously had a rough couple of weeks, but you know, they're a tough team. They're a big team. They know how to move the ball around. They've got some very classy arms. And you know, some good attacking people out there. So we need to be sharp and everything.
Does that make them a tougher prospect, considering you know what they can do, haven't been producing it, then you go across and play them at home when they're under pressure?
Oh, but they're always tough, as I said. You know, it's a matter of us making sure we turn up and do what they're capable of doing.
How much did that win over the Dogs last week give you confidence in what you can put out there?
I think for the last couple of weeks since we've sort of been growing, there was some quite quality teams over the last week or last month, really, you know, going into the Broncos and obviously the Storm and teams like that, you know, they're the people that are leading teams for competition. So, yeah, we've grown from those games and, you know, we were able to juice confidence we were chasing last week against the Dogs and then we'll go to the next week.
Everyone talks about having a winning habit, and you know, that winning is a habit. Two in a row, moving on to three in a row would be nice.
Oh, it is, yeah, definitely. You know, you feel it in the team, you know, the confidence in what they've been doing, and how hard they've been working, you know, it's definitely growing. So, you know, it is a bit of a habit, but maybe you should make sure it happens.
Rep side's test side picked on Sunday. Any of your blokes do you think deserve a bit?
Oh, I think, you know, it's up to the players. I think Big Stuart would have made a good start the other night, and he spoke about the players tend to pick themselves. And while they're practicing, you know, the players came up and played a tab, and you know, anyone could be able to show.
Do you think Dave Taylor deserves to win the Kangaroos?
Oh, look, I think the way Dave played last week was probably his best game for us. And, you know, his performance is very well. So, I'm sure he's trying to have a ring.
And Steve Maloney is going to be a pretty big battle. Johnny's been playing really well, but he's up against a pretty big name, I don't know.
I've been really happy with John's one. You know, John's been working really hard in his game and his competition. Every year he's got his game improved. So, you know, he's another one that cost him to his head in very correctly. He's got this week. So, John's really focused with his game and can improve him as well.
And always, expect boys to step up around that.
Yeah, definitely. You know, it's unfortunate to look at how hard Roy worked out here last season. You know, it's a big credit to getting out of that, you know, shape he was. But, you know, it's going to be something that's going to be, you know, we have a few young boys that are going to be in that, and similar to what everybody's done the last couple of weeks.
Speaking of Everingham, he's got a very big test ahead of him.
Yeah, he actually faced him in one of the games early on in the trials. So, you know, he's aware of the size. You know, it's been another challenge for Trevor to step up again. You know, he's been doing a great job for the team. You know, that's what Evo's about. He's been working hard for the team and produce performances.
How's Sam Burgess doing?
He's coming along really well. He's obviously for a couple of months. He's working hard to try and get himself back. You know, he's a frustrated kid at the moment.
Sammy, he's
working really hard to get back. You know, he's obviously really keen to get back on the park and a really disappointed kid, you know, with how hard he worked to get his body back to the way it was. But, you know, Sammy's supporting the team very well in the background, and, you know, I know when he comes back, he's going to be keen to go.
What about Nathan Merrick?
He ran for the first time this week, so, you know, hopefully he's turned into a he's a frustrated player, I guess, at the moment, because of the injury, but, you know, Merrick's not far off at the moment, so we're really keen to sort of push him down. See whether or not he might be available at this next couple of weeks.
Been happy with how GI's progressing?
Yeah, definitely. You know, what GI's doing now is he's hands on the ball a lot more, and you know, he's turning up all over the park, and that's what he's been lost for, and Greg's getting around the ball, and he's always a threat, as he's shown.
As a new coach, it obviously takes time for your systems and influence that comes through inside. Do you see that happening now, especially with the last couple of weeks?
Oh, I thought it was coming through pretty early on. It was just a matter of consistency doing that. You know, in a number of our games, we've probably just looked at the periods of time and other teams taken their opportunities, but, you know, sort of showed them against the Dogs. So they just played that 80 minutes and, you know, got the players to be impacted.
Let's go.
Thank you.